Hi, in part 2 of Awesome Lithophanes, I will show some lighting options for lithophanes using WS2812B LED strips, also known as neopixels. I start with simple static color lighting, then move ahead to bring some dynamics and using multiple colors, and finally building a LED matrix to achieve a photo-like appearance. I'm Tom and you're watching 3D Printing Geek. I'm using an ESP32 dev board here, but Arduino Nanos and similar will work as well. You will have to change the code examples to accommodate the pins you use. The programs are written using the ArduinoIDE. To use Neopixel LEDs, the Adafruit Neopixel library has to be provided. Go to Sketch, Include Library, Manage Libraries and search for Neopixel. Select the Arduino library for controlling single wire-based LED pixels and strip. Click Install and you're done. If you want to use an ESP32 instead of an Arduino Nano, then support for programming ESP32 has to be installed using the Boards Manager. First go to Preferences and click Next to the Additional Boards Manager URLs input box. In the dialog that opens, add the URL shown. Confirm all dialogs with OK. Then go to Tools, Boards, Board Manager and search for ESP32. Select the ESP32 by Expressive Systems and click on Install. Now you're ready to program ESP32s as well. The easiest lightings are of course static lightings. With NeoPixels you can choose from thousands of colors to display. The first thing to do is to import the library so that it can be used throughout the program. To program NeoPixels, one has to instantiate an instance of the Adafruit NeoPixel class representing the LED strip. Provide the number of LEDs in the strip and the type of strip as parameters. To initialize the strip class, call stripBegin. Set the brightness of the strip with the setBrightness function. I use a value of 40 here, which is approximately 1/6 of the maximum brightness. Then iterate through the number of pixels, starting from 0 up to the number -1. In each iteration you set the color of the LED with strip, set pixel color, the index of the LED you want to set the color for, and the R, G and B values. When all pixel colors have been set, the values are sent to the strip using strip show. Now upload the program to your micro. If there were no errors, the strip will be lit up with the colors you set and thus your lithophane will show in shades of that color. From the buff to dynamic lighting is simple. We only have to constantly change the single LED values and introduce a reasonable delay between these changes. In this example, I let only one LED move around the frame of the lithophane, setting the others to zero brightness. In each iteration, I increment the index of the active LED. The next example starts lighting each part of the frame in a different color: red, green, blue and yellow.
Banana.
Then, as before, I changed the indexes of where each color starts continuously and revert after a while. The modular division ensures that the LED's index always stays within the number of LEDs we have. As you can see, the colors blend in the edges where they meet, creating a pretty effect. Doesn't it look already great?
Great.
To achieve a rainbow effect, the color of each LED in the strip is changed slightly to build a gradient blending looking like a rainbow. The helper function wheel will return a matching color for the LED strip when given an indexed value between 0 and 255, returning an RGB color value for the strip. For two given indexes, they are close to each other, the colors are close to each other as well, so there's a gradient built when you cycle through the values from 0 to 255. The rainbow function makes use of the wheel function by iterating through each pixel of the strip, calling the wheel function to retrieve an adjacent color for each pixel and showing that. The possibilities are endless and only limited by your creativity and the technical limitations of the strip. Experiment with it. I'm curious to see your results. For my photo-like effect, the lighting around the borders won't work. Therefore, I built a custom 16x7 LED matrix. It allows me to use all the simple and dynamic approaches shown above and the one that I will demonstrate next. To achieve the photo look, I had to set the color of each pixel separately. Using GIMP and the color picker helped me to find the first values, which I then tweaked by hand. The result did not look satisfying at first because the colors fade and blend into each other and the photo looks washed out. Putting the LED matrix closer isn't an option because then the pixels get too sharp, destroying the illusion of a real photo that I wanted to achieve. A smarter solution is needed, and here it is. I thought that if I could prevent the light from each LED from blending too much with the adjacent LEDs, I would get a much improved result by means of sharpness and color. To do this, I printed a light grid which separates the LEDs a little bit from each other but still allowing some blending, and here's the result of that approach. Now it looks much crisper and natural. Links to the demo files as well as detailed instructions on how to install ArduinoIDE with ESP32 support can be found down in the descriptions. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any following videos, as well as giving me a thumbs up if you like this video and writing down your comments in the comment section. I'm curious to read what you think about it. Happy printing and see you soon. Bye!